So let us talk about supply decision of a firm operating in perfectly competitive market. Now we have already done the profit maximization. So we are going to do exactly the same thing, but slightly in different manner. What a firm does is maximize its profit, and we will write it like this: PQ minus CQ. Remember earlier when we were writing the profit maximizing function, we did it slightly differently. There we did maximize PF of K comma L minus RK minus WL. Right now we are not doing this, we are talking about maximizing profit as max selecting Q such that PQ, which is total revenue, minus CQ, which is total cost, gets maximized. And of course, the first order condition, because the firm is operating in the perfectly competitive market, this is fixed, this P doesn't change. So what would be the marginal revenue? If a firm sells one more unit, it will get P, and if firm sells one more unit, it will have to manufacture that particular unit. So how much is going to be the extra cost? That extra cost is going to be the marginal cost. Now it's very simple, if P is greater than the marginal cost, then firm should produce further. If P is less than MCQ, then firm should reduce its level of production. So when firm should stop the production? When P is equal to MC of Q. We have seen it earlier, but what we are going to do is to recast it as a Q as a function of P. Because what happens here? This is P, which is coming from the market, and this is the marginal cost, which depends on the technology available to the firm. And of course, here P as a function of, it's given P as a function of Q. So now what we are doing, we are rewriting this equation as Q as a function of P. In other words, we can have P and marginal cost, just for example, is 5 minus Q. We can rewrite it as Q is equal to 5 minus P. What we did here, that we wrote Q as a function of P, and this is what we are doing here theoretically, that Q as a function of P. This is what supply, of course we will have some modification, but to begin with, isn't it the supply function? What is the supply function? The firm's willingness to supply output in the market as a function of market price. This is the market price, this is the firm willingness to supply output. So this is basically the supply function of a firm operating in the perfectly competitive market. Okay, so but we have some disclaimer, and that we should focus on next, because remember we used only first order condition, and the from first order condition we got Q as a function of P. Remember when we were doing the profit maximization, we talked about that second order condition is also important, because it's very much possible that instead of doing the profit maximization, we are doing the profit minimization. Remember, the condition, mathematical condition, remains the same for profit maximization as well as minimization. Okay, so let us look at this condition when marginal cost first decreases and then increases. So this is marginal cost. Here it is as a function of Q, and let us say this is the market price, P. What happens? We see at two instances when Q is equal to Q1 and Q is equal to Q2, P is equal to marginal cost. If we pay attention to the first order condition, then it says that maximization happens at Q1 and Q2. But is it so? Let us look at it at Q1. What happens when a firm increases the production above Q1? what happens? The marginal cost goes down while P remains the same. It means if firm produces one Q1 plus one unit instead of Q1 unit, then the profit goes up. Why? Because marginal cost happens to be less than P. So firm earns a revenue of P while the cost is less than P. So this, of course, the profit maximization doesn't happen here. So where, but how about at Q2? At Q2, profit maximization happened, because let us see what happens if firm increases its production above Q2. If firm increases its production above Q2, then the marginal cost happens to be higher than the marginal revenue. So firm should not increase its production above Q2. How about below Q2? Below Q2, P is greater than the marginal cost. So if firm increases its production from a level which is lower than Q2, then this particular firm would increase its profit. So therefore, the profit is maximized at Q2. Profit is maximized at Q2. So in other words, we can say that we should ignore the downward sloping part of the MC curve. And why MC curve is important? If you look earlier, what I had said that supply function is an inverse of marginal cost function as related to P. So it's of course related. So now we have learned that we have to ignore the downward sloping part, because if we say that maximization is happening at downward sloping part, that would be wrong. So we have to concentrate on only upward sloping part. So we can say from here, we have changed our definition slightly. Earlier we said that the marginal cost curve would give us the supply function. Now we are having this particular modification that no, we have to focus on only on the upward sloping part. And why upward sloping part? It's clear, because downward sloping part doesn't give us the profit maximization. So that's one thing, one modification. Let us look at the second modification. We have to write the profit maximization function again, maximize with respect to Q, what we have PQ minus CQ. Okay? Let us compare two labels. Let's say if maximization is happening at Q2, let us compare at Q2 as well as Q2 with 0. So what I mean to say, this can be written as at Q2 PQ2 minus C of Q2, which is equal to PQ2 minus fixed cost minus variable cost at Q2. Let us say firm decides not to produce, then what would happen? The total cost is going to be minus FC. Okay. Now, if we compare these two, what happens? For firm to make profit, PQ2 minus FC minus VC Q2 has to be greater than minus FC. In other words, PQ2 should be greater than VC of Q2. Why? Because this will get cancelled. In other words, P should be greater than VC of Q2 divided by Q2, which is nothing but average variable cost at Q2. So profit maximization to happen, there is another condition now, that P has to be greater than average variable cost. Okay, so let us draw the graph again. We have here marginal cost curve. This graph you are familiar with. Then we have, this is average variable cost. And then we have, this is average cost. This is the minimum point of average cost, because marginal cost curve cuts the average cost curve from below at its minimum point, and same is true here. So now, earlier we started with the comment that the marginal cost curve gives us the supply function. Later we modified that only upward sloping part of the marginal cost curves gives us the supply function. And the next modification that came, that the P has to be greater than average variable cost. So this part, if it so happens, this part is upward sloping part, but in this zone firm would not supply. The reason is simple, that in if this is for supplying, this is the condition that we have. Here is the P. So what happens if, you know, the if firm produces at this level, then firm is not even able to recover the variable cost. And in that case, the firm would prefer to shut down. Okay, because firm is not even able to recover the variable cost. So firm would not supply in this zone. So after second modification, what is the case? That the supply function is given by upward sloping marginal cost function, which lies above the average variable cost function. So let me say here that only this part, if I use a different color, only this part gives us the supply function. So let us focus on shutdown. Let us take an example. What happens in the shutdown? Let us take an example that think about a hill station, and you see that off season during winter time in many hotels, they shut down their operation. What happens? They already have the fixed cost for building the rent and for to keep manager. But let us say if they employ some waiter and some cleaning personnel and some cook to cater to the customer, and the number is so low or the price is so low that the firm is not even able to recover the variable cost, then firm is better off by shutting down the operation. So that's the reason firm would not operate in that particular zone. Thank you.